I'm losing mine as well.
I don't. Is he losing?
It's getting thinner and thinner. Honestly, this takes ages. In an elevator, if I look in the mirror and the lights overhead, it looks like an X-ray. Honestly. It's just getting thinner and thinner, and I have to hide all the bald spots and everything. When I wake up in the morning, I look like a baby bird. It's just awful. And I'm trying to hold on to it, but it's fine. I'm not having a. I never wear a wig. I would never wear a wig. It's crazy. Guys, don't ever wear a wig.
You can't get away with it, right?
You can't get away with it. You walk into a room, you think, oh, well, no one knows. Everyone knows, right? Everyone. I was put off for life by my Uncle Reginald, right? A true story. So my Uncle Reginald, right, is a little guy, he went bald from early, like 21, 22.
Yeah.
He was completely bald from the age of 25 to 30-something, right? Just bald. Turns up one day, full head of hair. Just look Elvis at the door, right? And we were lied to. His family got embroiled. I remember when I was about 8, I asked my auntie why Uncle Reginald's hair grew back, and she went, "It's a miracle. It's a miracle." But they could never. He could never admit it. Never. He couldn't do anything. He'd run for a bus like that, just in case. Seriously.
A gust and of wind.
It must have been terrible. We weren't allowed balloons at parties, right? Because my auntie said, "Oh no, Uncle Reginald's allergic to balloons." He wasn't allergic to balloons. He was worried one of us would rub him on a jumper and his thing would come off.
I know the hair magnet trick. Yeah, no, you don't do that.
It's ridiculous. There's pictures of him. All the old pictures of him. Bless him. He's dead now. He wore that wig from 35 to he died about 75 a few years ago. He's buried with it.
Yeah.
It's probably still fine. It's probably a skeleton with a full head of hair. But we were looking back at old pictures of him at, like, weddings and christenings, and if he's holding a baby, he's always holding it at arm's length, so he can't grab his wig.
I didn't even think about that. Yeah, of course, yeah.
But his whole life, he couldn't do stuff.
Because of that wig, yeah.
Just the wig. I think he wore it at home, because if we went round and we knocked on the door, Auntie would look out, and then you'd see her go... Sort of put it on, they're coming in.
Be on lopsided. Like, oh, you surprised me.
But he had a wig, he had false teeth, he had hip replacement. By the time he died, he wasn't my uncle anymore, he was someone else.
He died someone else.
Someone else. So I'm just, I buzz it off when it goes. I'm never going to wear a wig.
No, it looks fantastic.